There's another question arises from this, which is, the computers are taking over all our thinking. They outstrip man. They're going to, or already have done. They think much faster. They can learn and unlearn. And so keep on learning and discover that their learning is not complete and learn further. Which means they are being programmed by experts and the machines. These computers can learn not only from the professors, from the programmers, but from themselves. Probably you know, some of you know about it, read about it. We have talked to some experts on computers, and within 10 years they say they are outstripped completely man. Will think faster. Learn faster, correct themselves, perhaps invent something new, new theories which man has not thought of. So there is this question, this is a very important problem for man. Of course, the computers cannot look at the stars and enjoy the stars. They can compose, perhaps not like Beethoven. Perhaps they do not know what love is. But neither do we. So there is this machine, which is ultra intellectual machine, ultra intellectual machine, it's called. They are inventing this. It's so rapid. So what becomes of man? You understand? Look at the problem, please. Face the problems, please. What happens to us who have lived by exercising our brain, whatever little part of that brain is, and that little part is being taken over by a machine which is Superman brain, then what happens to each one of us? What happens to our brain, which is no longer being employed as a thinking machine? I wonder if you follow all this. I'm afraid you don't. They are very concerned, some of us who have gone into this little bit, are very concerned what is going to be the future of man. When the machine can take over, all the activities of the brain. Then what happens to the brain? Either, there are only two possibilities. Either the brain pursues entertainment, football, which is already happening, sports, the religious entertainments, that's one direction, to be amused, entertained, or totally different thing, which is go pursue the inward process of man. the inward psychological discovery deeper and deeper. That those are the only two possibilities left to man. But the entertainment industry is already gaining. The televisions, if you know this, I don't have to. And there are very few who are concerned with the psychological understanding of man, completely, not the psychologists, not the professionals, not the psychiatrists, but you and I, who are the rest of mankind, we have to discover whether our brains are being trained by the entertainment industry to pursue that line. Please, this is awfully serious, all this. Do please pay attention to all this. Either we pursue that or turn inward, not selfishly, not egocentric movement or ego trip, but to understand the whole psychological movement, the self, the me, the ego, and see if it is possible to go beyond all that. So those are the only two paths left for us. If, when the computer takes completely over, the computer with the robot, you're already building cars. When the robot doesn't do properly, the computer tells it, it acts properly. You follow? So all that is being taken over gradually. So, what is a man to do? Understand my question? Do we think or observe individually, personally, from a particular condition, from a particular form of belief, prejudice? Or do we free ourselves from all that and turn inwardly, not self, please bear, not selfishly, not saying, I must save my soul, it's all too silly, but to enter into a world which will eventually dominate the outer, which it is doing now. The ambitious politician may use party politics, but the ambition, the personal ambition, it overrides everything else. This is also obvious. So psychologically one has to understand the whole structure of the human being. Is that possible? Have we time? Have we enough energy?